with more than 35 nations, 30,000 people, and a million components working together, we share one simple goal: to illuminate the way to new energy. Though fusion scientists all around the world are well aware of the ITER project, to many, ITER may yet remain a mystery. So to help the global public understand what's happening here, the ITER communication team coordinates free visits every day with journalists, researchers, policymakers, and curious citizens of all nations. Whether you want a tour of the worksite, to interview scientists, or study the international collaborative atmosphere of the ITER endeavor, all are welcome to reach out and schedule a visit.
So this is a unique opportunity for visitors to get a tailored, deep tour of the construction site. And they also get the chance to meet with people who explain their daily work at ITER and who give them latest updates on the construction site. Basically, anybody can come. You simply need a booking on our online tool.
We give them the chance, the opportunity to take the bus and to have a worksite tour, and also to go in the visitor center, and we can show them how a plasma is made and what are the main parts of a tokamak.
And I think to bring people and get them witness with their own eyes what's happening here on site is one of the best ways to promote the project and to bring sparkles in the eyes of the visitors.
Opala. Those with glasses.
Pretty special.
Don't forget your water.
So I used to work for a high energy accelerator research infrastructures, and I know how they look like, and I am so amazed to see a new equipment used here.
I'm really interested in what India is doing with particle physics. We also have a neutrino observatory underground coming up in India, and we're also involved in Fermilab in the US, which I got a chance to visit a few months ago. So I'm just taking things off my list, and it's amazing to see what we're doing with, you know, not a lot of resources.
The key feature of this building is the heavy crane, which is the tokamak machine. Is a big machine of 23,000 tons, so it's three times the weight of the Eiffel Tower.
I personally am very fond of these huge marvels of physics, particularly engineering and physics. From my background in engineering, I can understand what are the limitations in terms of time and resources and money which companies and organizations face when they're building such a project. But I believe that they're doing well, and I think we can expect good results in due time. I still am a student. I'm dealing with my dissertation and other stuff. But what I really loved about this experience is that it was immersive. Like we were in there, and we were walking through those phases of manufacturing and production, and those engineers were explaining things, and I feel happy that I can understand some of those terms because of what I studied earlier, so that gets me even more excited. I have tried not just to capture the location and how it looks, I've tried to capture some people while they're working. I like to see people, the emotion that they have, and they do look invested into this thing.
So I'm a PhD student. I come from the Netherlands. I study at Leiden University, and I came here to conduct interviews with people working at ITER. I look into the organizational structure of ITER, and I asked the communication department if I could come to visit and to conduct these interviews, and I'm very grateful that they were able to accommodate this wish, and I had a great time here. And apparently those people would like to make the time for me, and they also said that they were very interested themselves in hearing more about this research. Everyone was very open and was very happy to receive me and to share their stories about their life and work at ITER. And reading first about it and then seeing it in real life, that has been amazing.
I can see from my window that the project is really progressing, and I'm very happy to see that we have a lot of visitors and to contribute in a very smaller way to make this project advancing.
ITER is not just a dream, it's becoming a reality here in the south of France, and every day it's like a blessing. I'm really happy to be part of this fantastic adventure.
Everyone is very human, very warm, and people like us to talk about their work and what they're doing here. So it's really amazing to share a bit in this enthusiasm and passion. as an outsider, but now today and yesterday also a bit as an insider to see ITER from the inside.
Konnichiwa!
Bonjour.
Bonjour. Shall we do it again? Yeah.
Okay.
Konnichiwa.
Bonjour et bienvenue. Welcome back to ITER Now. This is the end of the video. Thank you for making it this far. You asked some very tough questions this week.
Oh yeah, you did.
So we're happy to get into them.
So Leif, thank you for the question. Ask us what waste produce from fusion reactor process.
Waste, right. Well, the fusion reaction itself only produces a small amount of inert helium and a really hot neutron, which we use to create energy as byproducts. So that's very negligible. Mm-hmm. However, the machine itself, ITER, has made up a bunch of metals on the inside of the machine that will be activated by the stuff in the plasma. Mm-hmm. And that is going to be sort of a hazard for about 100 years only. So unlike fission, where you take a big nucleus of uranium or something, you break it apart, and it creates this radioactive waste which lives for hundreds, like thousands of years. This will produce a small amount of waste that can be stored right here on site. Yeah. And in about 100 years, it's totally harmless to the environment, to everything.
So we can say fusion energy is clean energy, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Safe. Mm-hmm. And very little waste.
Yeah.
But check out our website for a more scientific answer than that still. Too. Someone named Hyperion1010 says, what happens after Brexit? Oh. Will Britain's contribution to ITER remain intact?
Yes, of course. So basically nothing changes in 11 months, the transition period. Some contracts may need to be negotiated. However, the country, the UK, said they want to remain and stay involved in the project and contribute to this project. So,
right. And as far as like employees who have contracts working here, their contracts will be honored and nothing will really change as far as any of that's concerned.
So the question from the Art of on YouTube, thank you. I love what you guys are doing.
Nice.
Yeah, ITER is absolutely fantastic. But isn't the advancement of Stellarators. Can I do that again?
Sure, okay.
Stellarators. Isn't the advancement of Stellarators rendering this obsolete?
Ah, well, definitely not, you know. So Stellarators, as opposed to tokamaks, these are two different types of machines that are doing fusion. The biggest Stellarator that exists right now is the W7X in Germany. And it's definitely, we're not in competition with any of these other types of fusion. And tokamaks are more researched, they're more tested, it's a safer bet so far. But that doesn't mean we don't want Stellarators being tested. Stellarators and tokamaks definitely have fans in the scientific community. Yeah. Both are supported. You know, the main difference, like our tokamak has like a smooth inner surface where the plasma pieces basically have to do these little spins all the way around. And the Stellarator, the magnets themselves are spun in a really twisted, interesting way. It looks like a snake of like spaghetti or something.
Spaghetti.
And so that the plasma basically can go in more of a straight line because the magnets themselves are twisted. That's the difference. But no, you know, like we want all fusion things to be moved on. Like if we succeed first, it doesn't mean that like, all the Stellarators will turn off and stop doing research. Like the people who lead these Stellarators and tokamaks, we all share information freely, completely openly. So we're informing each other's processes, and we're all trying to reach the same goal.
Yeah, of fusion energy.
Create fusion.
Yeah.
So thank you. Thank you for your questions very much. I hope we keep doing this. Keep sending good questions.
Yep.
Keep suggesting fun photos we can put on the green screen here. Honestly, we're still working out the green screen. Look, we're pretty green yet in the background. I'm working on the chroma keying. Someone else commented on that. Thank you for the tip. We're still figuring it out, but yes.
Okay.
Thank you for listening. Merci beaucoup.
Sayonara.
Okay, see you next time on ITER Now.
Bye. Stellarators.
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 Yeah, Stellarators.
Stellarators.
Perfect.
Stellarator.